Audio Architect is the software used to configure, control, and monitor a multitude of Harman HiQnet devices, including Soundweb London and DCI. To put Audio Architect into perspective, we need to examine the past. Prior to 2013, there were two Harman software applications used for installed sound products: London Architect and System Architect. London Architect was used for BSS audio devices, while System Architect was used for nearly all other Harman HiQnet devices. This forced system integrators to learn and deploy two separate software applications in order to build a functional system. Frankly, this separation was less than ideal because it didn't fully leverage the synergies between the Harman brands. So in 2013, Harman said, "Let's make it easier for our customers. Let's combine the two software applications into one, and let's call it Audio Architect." Stated simply, Audio Architect equals London Architect plus System Architect. Since the Soundweb London hardware is now compatible with two software applications, it's natural to compare the two. So let's do just that. Aside from a few temporary feature omissions, Audio Architect is far more powerful than London Architect. In 2013, the first release of Audio Architect excluded several features to which London Architect users had grown accustomed. But with each subsequent release, this list of excluded features has grown shorter and shorter. Eventually, all significant London Architect features will be implemented within Audio Architect. Thus, the use of the word temporary. So, depending on when you're watching this video, this feature migration might have already completed. For a current summary of Audio Architect feature support relative to London Architect, please visit this website. Now, here are some of the benefits of using Audio Architect instead of London Architect. Audio Architect offers easier integration with other Harman products because everything now happens within one software application. Also, a greater depth of integration is now possible. For example, you can now link BSS audio parameters directly to Crown parameters. The matching and going online process is now a bit more intuitive because things are based on drag and drop operations. There's easier panning and zooming with the mouse, which means you can move around more naturally. Control panel management is now easier. First, instead of relying on a scrolling tab system, control panels are now accessible from the more familiar Windows taskbar. Also, while offline, controls are operational by default, and there's no need to enter any special mode or to use keyboard shortcuts. It's now easier to access and program GPIO ports without having to dig deeply into any tree structure to find them. It's also easier to create and manage parameter presets with clearly labeled buttons and a much more informative layout. There are now ways to create presets while online. You can now set up email triggering, so if something good or bad happens in the system, you can receive an email about it. The Matrix Mixer GUI is now both easier to use and a bit more attractive by default. The BloomLink management screen is now laid out more intuitively, with signals always flowing from left to right. It's now easier to determine third-party control strings for any HiQnet device, and you can even export that data to a spreadsheet for easy documentation. It's also easier to set up iPads and iPhones as controllers, because you no longer need to export and import raw data between two software applications. There are now factory-supplied templates integrated into the software, which you can use to get up and running very quickly. And Soundweb Contrio devices are the first example of a BSS audio product supported only within Audio Architect, not London Architect. And that'll be the trend going forward. London Architect will receive maintenance updates only, and all new feature development will take place within Audio Architect. Therefore, expect this list to grow over time. In later videos, we'll go into greater detail about how to actually use Audio Architect, but next, let's talk about networked audio.